the country is run by Islamic, you know, politics. The governments have been very rigid and very harsh in this after the 79 revolution, trying really to establish the value of Islam inside the country, because people have seen the harshness of religious government inside the country. They have lost their trust and in Islam and in government, and many of them are just openly saying, we don't want Islam, we don't want, you know, Arabic leader, you know, kind of leadership never matches Iranian history, Iranian culture, you know, we don't want it. So people are frustrated by religion and by religious leader, and they are exhausted. Praise God that people are searching for any other way and solution, and that has caused people, many of them, give their hearts to the Lord. We don't know the exact statistic, and people say hundreds of thousands, and some, you know, news agents are saying to us more than millions. Oh my goodness, Christians were slaughtered there, and almost all Protestant churches are closed down by government. Government forced them to close their churches, and many pastors were killed. You know, even one church has given so far 11, you know, martyrs, and many Christians are in prison because they do not know leaders in Iran. They think that Islam is the only perfect and last religion. They do not know their religion in the context of the world. In other words, like us Christians, to compare our belief with Hinduism, with Islam, with Buddhism, with atheism, with New Age, whatever, because we want everything to be clear for us. But that's not the mindset in Islam. In Islam, you were born inside the frame of Islam. You have to live inside the frame of Islam. You have to continue life inside the frame of Islam. And any member of your family gets out of that frame is enemy to Islam, enemy to Islamic world, and is in war with us. We have to kill that person. Every day they're carrying their sentence with themselves. You know, Christians are forbidden. Christians evangelism is forbidden in Islamic countries. You know, you and I cannot go there to evangelize about Christ, but they cannot stop Christ. Christ penetrates everywhere. He's the wonderful evangelist, and he's a powerful evangelist. So we need to ask him prayer from him. Go, Lord, break the wall, go and touch the hearts through dreams, through visions, through personal touch, you know. That's one thing. That's the less costly thing for us to do, you know, in England and in all over the world. And the second thing is really we need to make our voices stronger. It's amazing that 75% of persecution now is about Christianity. And also we need to touch our pockets, because these people have lost a lot of things. People who leave their families, you know, they leave their religion, they lose everything. So we need to stand behind these brothers and sisters as much as we can, because that's the greatest investment we can do for our beloved Jesus.